Today we discuss second lecture regarding changes after death. The early changes. In my previous lecture, I told you about liver mortis. Today we study rigor mortis. Stiffening of the muscles after death. Before starting the proper topic, changes in muscles after death. A theory question. The changes in muscles after death. These changes are primary relaxation or flaccidity, rigor mortis. Third one is the secondary relaxation, and fourth is the cadaveric spasm. These are the four changes occur in muscles after death. I told you about primary relaxation and secondary relaxation in my initial lectures. Today we discuss rigor mortis and cadaveric spasm. These are the early changes: rigor mortis, algal mortis, liver mortis, and biochemical changes. We study rigor mortis under following headings: definition, mechanism, distribution of rigor, diagnosis of rigor, factors influencing rigor, conditions simulating rigor mortis, and medico-legal importance of rigor mortis. The definition of rigor mortis. Rigor mortis is the stiffening of dead body results from temperature dependent physiochemical change that occurs within muscle cells due to lack of oxygen. Rigor mortis is the stiffening of the dead body results from temperature dependent physiochemical change that occurs within muscle cells due to lack of oxygen. Rigor mortis follows the period of primary flaccidity or primary relaxation. Rigor mortis indicates death of individual cells, that is molecular death. Mechanism of rigor mortis. Cessation of respiration leads to lack of oxygen. Decreased glycolysis ceases ATP formation. Anaerobic glycolysis, lactic acid production, cell cytoplasm become acidic. Low ATP and high acidity, actin and myosin fibers bind together and forms a gel. These complex cellular metabolic changes result in muscle stiffness. At the time of somatic death, ATP is present in muscle to maintain process of relaxation. There is gradual ATP breakdown to ADP and phosphate till glycogen is available in the muscles. And there is a resynthesis of ATP. This explains why skeleton muscle survive more than 6 hours. As we discuss, the survival period of different body organs after somatic death. For skeleton muscle, 6 hours. This explains why the skeleton muscle respond to electric stimuli and become live after up to 6 hours of death. With depletion of glycogen and anaerobic respiration, constant accumulation of lactate and phosphate in the muscle, no further ATP production. Muscles begin to lose softness, elasticity, and extensibility. Distribution of rigor. Distribution, first development, distribution, disappearance, and degradation of rigor, more properly the heading may be. From head to toe, the rigor develop from head to toe fashion, both in voluntary and involuntary muscles, paralyzed and amputated limbs. The development phase starts 2 to 4 hours, fully developed in 9 to 12 hours. First demonstrated in the eyelids within 3 to 4 hours, face 4 to 5 hours, neck and trunk 5 to 7 hours, upper limb 7 to 9 hours, lower limb 9 to 11 hours, finger and toes 11 to 12 hours. So developmental phase 9 to 12 hours, it remains the static phase another 12 hours and vanishing phase or passes off phase another 12 hours. So it's also known as a rule of 12. Rule of 12. 12 hours to develop, 12 hours to persist, and 12 hours to vanish or to pass off. The rigor disappear in the same fashion as followed in onset. Degradation. The dissolution of rigor mortis is due to protein degradation. Increase of ammonia as decomposition sets. Rigor mortis in internal organs and pupil. First, pupil. The rigor mortis causes contraction of pupils at the time of somatic death. There is a dilatation of pupil, but in a phase of rigor mortis, pupil may show little bit constriction or contraction. The uneven size of pupil is an antemortem abnormality of iris, not a postmortem phenomenon. The rigor mortis in the internal organs. The rigor mortis first appears in heart at end of first hour after death. This also explains that cardiac muscle cannot withstand with the oxygenation, deprivation of oxygenation after somatic death. Rigor mortis causes contraction of left heart. They become found empty during this phase. Rigor mortis effect Dartos muscles of scrotum that compresses the testes and epididymis, which causes postmortem emission of semen. That also occur in primary relaxation due to loss of erectile tone. Emission of semen, incontinence of urine and feces. Diagnosis of rigor. Lifting of eyelids, more accessible part, and initially the eye muscle shows rigor mortis as rigor develop from head to toe fashion, so appear externally first in the eyes. Lifting of eyelids, orbiculus oculi, depressing of lower jaw, a lateral pterygoid muscle and gravity. You see that when death occur, people trying to close the mouth. Once the rigor set, it is very difficult to close the mouth, close the lower jaw. As seen in the figure, across a joint of upper limb, elbow joint, biceps, and knee joint, the quadriceps muscle to test the quadriceps muscle, in upper limb to test the bicep muscle, using a gentle pressure from one or two fingers only. M is to test the rigor, not to break it. Once rigor break, muscle cannot reliably be tested again. Improper handling of bodies from scene of crime to mortuary, morgue, untrained persons in. So it is usually rigor is break. In expert hands, rigor is tested with appropriate measures. Even when the clothes on, to cut the clothes from the stitch line, the care should be taken that do not apply the lot of force to break the rigor. So there is a misinterpretation occurs. The factors which influence the presence of rigor mortis: temperature, body temperature, environment, and micro temperature environment. The body temperature is postmortem calorosity, a condition poison which causes hyperthermia, poisons which causes hypothermia, environment, rain, storm, humidity, cold, and micro environment in a centralized heating system, a centralized cooling system, all may affect the rigor mortis. Colder the temperature, slower the reaction, and vice versa. In cold environment, rigor will be delayed and remain for prolonged duration, 24 to 48 hours. in warm environment, rigor will be early, appear early, and remains for shorter duration, 18 to 36 hours. Age and health condition, children, old and emaciated, rigor is poorly developed. Conditions prior to death, electrocution, convulsion poisons, epilepsy, and muscular activity, metabolic acidosis, there is early onset of rigor and passes off early. Rigor absent in septicemia. If fetus less than 7 months, rigor do not demonstrated, or do not appreciable, or perceptible, because low muscle mass. In children, old and emaciated person, rigor mortis is hard to detect because of physique. In good build, there is a late onset and longer duration. In thin build people, early onset and early passes off. Colder the temperature, slower the reaction. As we mentioned earlier, warmer the temperature, faster the reaction. In winter, it will take 24 to 48 hours. In summer, 18 to 36 hours. Thymulating conditions, heat stiffening. And the key point is more than 70 degree centigrade, the protein coagulate, and a pugilistic attitude, a boxer attitude, they commonly seen in the victims of heat stiffening. So heat stiffening occurs in burning, high voltage electrocution, immersion into a hot liquid. Heat coagulates the proteins of the muscles and causes stiffening and contraction to a greater degree than that is seen in the rigor mortis. A pugilistic attitude or boxer attitude, and upper and lower limbs are semi-flexed and the hand clenched. This is the position known as boxer's position or pugilistic attitude, occurs in heat coagulation. Rigor mortis do not develop in heat stiffening, which persist until the coagulated albumin liquefies in the process of decomposition, also known as in the process of decomposition or process of putrefaction, a degradation of the proteins, putrefaction. Cold stiffening. At 4 degree centigrade, there is a solidification of fats and muscles. The intense cold solidifies the subcutaneous fat, solidification, and the process of rigor mortis is geared suspended till body is exposed to warmer environment, known as process of thawing. Then true rigor mortis appear with great rapidity and passes off quickly and had decreased intensity. Cadaveric spasm, we discuss in the last, comparing in contrast with the rigor mortis. This is heat stiffening, a pugilistic attitude, flexion of the upper and lower limbs, a boxer's attitude. The condition may simulate rigor mortis, but this contraction of muscle is so rigid and so strong than seen in the rigor mortis. This is rigor mortis. Look at the position of the hands. How to test the rigor? In previous slide, the testing of rigor in the upper limb. In this slide, the testing of rigor in the lower limb across the knee joint. Cadaveric spasm versus rigor mortis. Definition, time of occurrence, brain relaxation, occurrence, muscle affected, mechanism, medical legal importance. Cadaveric spasm. It is a state of group of muscles instead of going into primary relaxation after death, go into sudden state of stiffening. This cadaveric spasm, also known as cadaveric rigidity, cataleptic spasm, instantaneous rigor. Actually, instantaneous rigor is misnomer. This is not the proper rigor condition. It's totally different from the rigor mortis. So cadaveric spasm is a state of group of muscles, voluntary muscles, instead of going into primary relaxation that occurs in a somatic death, after death go into the sudden state of stiffening instead of relaxation. Time of occurrence, just at the time of death, while rigor mortis occurs 3 to 4 hours after death. Primary relaxation absent in rigor mortis, in cadaveric spasm, while rigor follows primary relaxation. Occurrence, the cadaveric spasm occurs rarely in rare condition, while rigor mortis always in every death. Muscles affected, voluntary muscles, group of muscles, while in rigor mortis all muscles affected, both voluntary and involuntary. Mechanism of cadaveric spasm, a possibly neurogenic and still unknown mechanism, but possibly neurogenic, while mechanism of rigor mortis is physiochemical change. Medico-legal importance. The cadaveric spasm may indicate the manner of the death, or it may record the last act of life. For example, a soldier died in kneeling position with his ammunition targeted towards the enemy, do not respond to the verbal command, found dead in that position. A weird sentence in hands of a drowned person. A firmly grasped trigger of a weapon in suicidal shooting. So these are the example where which records the last act of life, shows the cadaveric spasm. While rigor mortis, medical legal importance, it is an indicator of sign of death, and it helps in rigor mortis, helps in estimation of time since death. This is cadaveric spasm. A weeds and twigs grasped in a hand of a drowned person. Sometimes button, hairs, and any other object of a silent. In case of homicidal death. So this fist is so firm, very difficult to open. So possibility of manner of inflection may be inferred from cadaveric spasm. Thank you very much.